Welcome to PowerPoint Bro. Today, I want to share how to create parallax animation in PowerPoint with the morph transition. By the way, I plan to make some tutorials on parallax animation in the future. And in this video, I'm going to start with a simple and elegant transition like this. I named it Simple White Parallax Transition. I hope this tutorial will be useful, and let's start the tutorial. First, I have prepared this stock image that I'll use as a slide background. This flower photo on the left will I use for the first slide background. And this forest photo on the right will I use for the second slide background. Before entering the next step, I recommend you to enable grid lines, so that later we can see the size and position of slides that might be covered by images. Okay, for the next step, select these two images. Place them together in the center of the slide. Size it up until it fills the slide. In this parallax animation, I want it will move from bottom to top. So, in this slide, we have to align this image to the top of this slide. We will have some extra picture areas below the slide. For this forest's background, crop this image from top to bottom until it is below the slide, like this. This slide will be the first slide, with this flower image for the slide background. After that, duplicate this slide. On this second slide, we will animate the position a little bit, moving from the bottom to the top. Select both images, then move them up until the bottom side of the image touches the bottom side of the slide, as you can see like this. Now we're going to create a wipe animation effect for this forest picture using picture cropping. Open crop, resize and transform the cropping area until it fills the slide area like this. Now let's see how it will look when we play the transition. Open the transition tab and choose morph transition. I think this animated wipe is pretty cool, but let's give it a little touch that will give a more dynamic effect. Let's make these two images a little bit bigger. There will be a little zoom effect from the first to second slides. Select both photos, then group them. Scale it up a little like this. Then it's done. Next, ungroup these two photos again. We have done this white parallax transition effect. It would be nice if we tidy up the cropping size and area of the picture for both slides like this. Now, let's animate the objects on this slide. This sample text and shape will I use for the slide content. I'm going to do it slowly, and I hope you can understand it easily. On this first slide, select all existing objects. Then copy and paste on the second slide. Do not release the selection, then move its position above the slide area. Then, unselect the bottommost object by pressing Shift plus click. Then move the object selection upwards a little bit. Do the same thing to the object above it, like this. By changing the position like this, the topmost object will move faster and further than the object below it. See this example. We will get more parallax effect when we also make a spacing difference for each object. Then, for this second slide, do the same thing as the object on the first slide, like this. Copy all object elements from the second slide and paste them into the first slide. Remember, do not release the selection, then change its position below the slide like this. Do the same as the object from the first content on the second slide. Take a good look. Now let's play the transition. And it's done. Maybe if you find this tutorial looks quite challenging and complicated, I make sure it will be effortless when you make this white parallax transition more and more. Replay this video from the beginning, then follow it while practicing it in PowerPoint to understand this tutorial quickly. You can improvise from this wiping parallax transition and create different transition effects variations like this. Get creative and share what you have created by following this tutorial at the PowerPoint Bro Discord server. I hope this tutorial is useful and see you in another video.